years at the University of Illinois, I've had the good fortune of working for a number of startup companies, some that have done chips for the PC industry, some that have done video games, some that have done chips for the video gaming industry. And today, I want to talk about my newest venture. A little bit of a problem with the video. Here he comes. My newest venture called Nuvixa. And the company deals with presence. And today we all have the good fortune of being physically present in the same space. So I'm here, you're here. But there are people watching this that aren't here. They're watching the videos, the video feed off the internet, or perhaps they're watching a podcast at some point down the road. For them, they don't get the full experience of my presence on stage. One second, let me see if I can help with this. There we are. Oh, you sort of spoiled my punchline, but that's okay. So, those watching over the internet don't quite get the same experience that you and I are experiencing. They don't see my virtual presence. The best they get is a disembodied voice. And thanks to the excellent filming crew here, they might see cutaway scenes between my slides, the points that I want to talk about, and me. They don't necessarily get the advantage of presence. So, let's talk about presence, and let me tell you the ways in which Nuvixa and the technology we've developed here at Illinois can help us have a deeper, more emotionally connective virtual presence. It all starts with video. You know, voice is one thing, but video starts to give us that presence. And we can look back to the days when this notion of videos first started to appear in our mindset. Embodied by the picture phone that AT&T developed in the early 60s. This brought us to the great age of a place where everybody's talking on the phone, looking at each other, flying around in jetpacks. It was a future that never quite materialized in the way that was envisioned by the people who brought the picture phone to us. It actually even started far, far further back than the 1960s. Here's a postcard from the turn of from the 1900s, in the early days of voice telephony, where the pioneers of voice imagined a future where there was video. It's a postcard from France. Apparently, what's happening is this good man is engaged in a video phone call with somebody that's not quite there. Well, if we zoom forward 100 years. The caption there said, in the year 2000. And if we go to the year 2000, it turns out that they weren't that far off. So here's what a video presence solution looks like in the year 2000, flickering on and off, where there is equipment in a special place for people to start to become virtually present with one another. It's odd. You have to go to a special room in order to be virtually present. Now, I would say that they weren't too far off. Maybe they got the fashion wrong, but the idea of going to a special place with special equipment is what happened in the year 2000. But I think things are quite different than this. And I wish the video wouldn't flicker, but it does. So, what we have today is, thanks to the internet and the advent of very cheap, very powerful mobile computing, the ability for anybody to effectively make a phone call from their PC and talk to somebody that's somewhere else. So you can actually now be virtually present for free with things like video chat through Skype or Google. Okay, do we have presence yet? We're getting there. These are all critical elements. Actually, I should say one more thing here. If you look at the statistics on Skype video over the last quarter of 2009, the last 3 months, 30 billion minutes logged on Skype. A third of all Skype calls involve video. So it's a modality that's becoming pervasive. All around the world, people are connecting to each other, either in a good way or a bad way, in a satisfactory way or not, through video. But I ask the question, do we have presence yet? It's not going to feel like I'm physically there, wherever there may be, but I'm going to tell you about a technology that I think is going to make it be even better. So I can be here, wherever here is, without any special equipment except for what's mounted on my laptop here, which I'll tell you about more in a moment. But I'm here in a virtual space, which happens to be blank, but it need not be. It could be my presentation. So I can tell you about what I'm trying to convey in a more expressive, more present way. I can articulate my points with my body. You see my facial expressions. You get my point better. No longer a disembodied voice, or a cutscene, or a box of video, but I'm me. I'm now more present. Not very interesting to be present on PowerPoint, I have to admit. I'd much rather be here. In fact, I'd much rather be here playing Leonardo's chimes. But I'm not a very good dancer or a musician, so you probably don't want to hear that. But I would love to have a video chat with a colleague in this kind of environment. Dennis, are you there?
Oh, yeah, sure. Hi, Sanjay. How is the conference going?
It's a great conference. We're having lots of great dialogue, seeing lots of great presentations. Okay. Dennis, would you mind telling us how this is actually working?
Sure. So if you take a look, what we have here are our cameras so that have special features. If you look at the bottom part here, that's just a regular camera, the kind that you can normally buy in a regular store, the ones that we have today. But in addition to that camera, we have illuminators on the side here that shoot out an invisible beam of IR radiation, which is then sensed by this extra sensor up here. And that extra sensor, what it does is it provides us depth information. So, and with the depth information, I can separate me from the boring furniture that's behind me and transport only the important parts, and it makes me fit on the screen a lot better. Also, since we control the lighting, even though it's invisible lighting, we can get much better results than if we try to do this with, say, a regular camera or even a set of regular stereo cameras.
Thanks a lot, Dennis.
Oh, yeah, thank you. Have fun.
Bye. So that's what presence is all about. I want to emphasize that this technology that you're seeing here that Dennis talked about briefly is something that I think everybody will have access to in the next few years. So the kinds of presence that you and I will be able to do are going to be radically improved, better emotional connection than what we're seeing even today. Thank you.